Problem number 24. Simplify the radical expression. We have the square root of 49 x cubed y 7. So not everything under the square root is a perfect square. What I'm going to do is I'm going to split it into my perfect square roots and my non-perfect square roots. The 49 is a perfect square, so it goes into my perfect square roots. Then x to the third power is not a perfect square, but I can split the x cubed into x squared and 1x. Remember, when you multiply these back together, you get x cubed. And when you're dealing with square roots, you need to make the exponent of the variable divisible by the index. In this case, the index is 2, so it needs to be an exponent that is divisible by 2. And the closest one, if I have 3 x's, would be 2. Okay, now y to the 7. Again, my exponent needs to be divisible by 2, and the closest number less than 7, which would be divisible by 2, is 6. So in my perfect square roots, I have y to the 6th power, and then 1y left over in my non-perfect square roots. Now I'm ready to take the square roots of my perfect squares. So right here, the square root of 49 is 7. The square root of x squared is just x. The square root of y to the 6th power is y to the 3rd. Remember, divide by 2. So 6 divided by 2 is 3. And then left is my x and my y, which are non-perfect square roots. So my final answer is 7xy cubed and the square root of xy.